Hello guys, the DB Grinder here, back at it again with another video, and this time we have NJets versus Paulo, PRRJ, Goncalves, and this is the LCS Round 5. Also, make sure to check out Luxury and Paulo down below in the description. And with that being said, let's hop right into the video, and then we are going to see Paulo win the Rock, Paper, Scissors, Shoot. And then looking at the deck counts, we can see 40 versus 40. Gotta love to see it. And Paulo is going to decide to go first. Opening hands, we have Veiler, Bell, Roxy's, Fusion Spell, and Water. So this is good. You know, multiple hand traps going second. Multiple pranks plus a Fusion Spell. You can't really ask for much more. And then they have Bell, Rescue Cat, Nerval, Reval, and Fractal. So they are going to start off with Normal Summon Out Cat. And then on summon, hit that with Veiler, but they do have the extender. And then Fractal effect, go dump Kit. Kit dump Nerval. Nerval effect, add Kuraz. And then they are going to go ahead and activate Kuraz. Get rid of Nerval, summon that out. Then looks like they're thinking here, they're going to use the effect, banish 4, to go ahead and summon out the Omen. And then link those two away to go in the Blossom. And then Omen effect to go search. Searching out from the deck to the hand a Fractal. Then effect, special summon out Fractal. Fractal effect, banish 2. Summon the double Dragon Lords. And then turn all of those into an Appaloosa. And then draws into Puppy. Okay, so they are playing the Melfi cards. So they're going to draw and then put the puppy back, and then set, and then pass turn. So this isn't bad, you know, Revolt, Bounce, Appaloosa, Bell, and then they draw Desires. That's insane. Okay, go ahead and activate Desires, you know, Free Product Greed, draws in a Fusion Spell, Field Spell. Okay, Field Spell is honestly insane. Like, it's so good. Looking at the banishes. Holy, they banished like a lot of multiple hand traps, which doesn't really matter, but still, it just looks weird. They banished a Fire, a Water, and a Roxy's. So, not too bad. They didn't banish like multiples of anything. Then they're going to activate Field Spell, and this will go ahead and search out Wind from the deck to the hand. Also, I got something in my eye. Definitely sucks, but go ahead, Normal Summon out Wind. They're going to activate Revolt here. Then this will resolve. Also, last video I posted, I'm pretty sure it was the exact same player versus Tri-Brigade. They were like, why didn't they Bell? Appaloosa. card says negate. So, my Blossom was regular summon, don't remember. Yes, it was. They used the Omen and the Rescue Cat to link summon into the Blossom. So they are going to go ahead and summon out those monsters, get rid of them, summon Omen, and then get the effects. It will go ahead and search from the deck to the hand, and then draw, put back, and then banish. And they do draw another hand trap, which is good. Then activate Fusion Spell, get rid of 2, go for Rocket Ride. And then get those effects. So we'll go ahead and summon out Fire, banish, draw Called By, summon out Wind. Called By will be good. It'll be able to trade with a hand trap. Then activate Ancient Warriors to try to bounce Rocket Ride here. Why? Why do you do that right here? Like, I feel like that's kind of weird. Like, if they Rocket Ride, like, they Rocket Ride Tribute for effect, right? Appaloosa go Burr. If they go Battle Phase, Ancient Warriors then bounces, forcing them to have said Battle Phase. You know, obviously they can link and then do that, but why would you not just wait? I feel like that's a good negate with Appaloosa. I feel like that's not such a great bounce with the Ancient Warriors here, though. Omen effect to go searching out from the deck to the hand. They're going to add Fractal. That's a little interesting. So they could have added the kit or an omen or a Nerval. I meant to say Nerval. They could have added Nerval there too if they wanted to. And then get rid of those for Doodle. They're going to be getting those effects. All four. Chainlink 5 Veiler. And then Chainlink 6 called by on the Veiler. Couldn't they have actually just like let that resolve? Like, does the Veiler really matter? Like, you already have fusion spell. You get to summon. Like, does Veiler actually do anything here? I feel like you could just hold on to this. And then, like, yeah. I feel like you definitely hold on to called by. If they have another hand trap, you can called by it. If not, the next turn, instead of just, like, instantly doing the battle butter, you can just called by, hit the Fractal out of graveyard. Or, like, any Tri-Brigade they summon, you can just go ahead and hit out of graveyard, because they have all of them in graveyard. I feel like, it's a little bit interesting. But let's see how they end up playing it out. I still think they're in a pretty decent position here, for sure. Get rid of those. Or not getting rid of those. Okay. Get rid of water to go for Meow. And then get rid of those to go for Bow Wow. Then they are going to go battle phase here. Then Doodle, attack Appaloosa. And they take 11 there. I'm just going to trust their math because, like, you know, this is getting an attack. That loses attack. So I'm going to just trust that they're doing math good here. I don't feel like calculating it out. Tribute Doodle. And then this will go ahead and try to add back. They're going to chain Bell to stop that. Ah, see? They did mess it up. But, yeah, go ahead, Tribute Doodle into a Bell. And then set Fusion Spell, activate Pranks, end phase, Pranks effect. Go ahead and put back. I guess, like, they just wanted to beat over the Ancient. Which... Not bad. Yeah, I definitely get that. But I feel like, I don't know. Maybe they are right with that. Like, wanting to beat over the Ancient Warriors. Because the way I was saying it would have left the Ancient Warriors there. Beat over Appaloosa. But you'd have the last Prank Kids. So, like, you'd be able to go for Battle Butler. But I guess, like, Battle Butler would be forced out by a double Dragon Lords. Or you just... no, because if you don't beat over Appaloosa, then you just negate that. So you beat over this, you leave this, and then this will trade with the Battle Butler anyways. But then they have to wait. Nah, because then, like, you get to trade with the normal summon plus this with the Battle Butler. And then you have a whole bunch of Prank Kids on board. Yeah, I like that. I like the play that I said. And if they don't have Bell, then you get to use called by on, like, the normal summon effect. So you don't even have to Battle Butler then. They draw Imperm off the draw, then they draw Obedience Schooled. Okay. I like what Paulo's throwing down here. I don't think this was, like, poorly played on their part. I think I would have just tried to approach it differently. But this still isn't, like, bad, though. Normal summon out Fractal. Then they are going to activate Fractal effect, banish 2, summon out Blossom. And then they are going to Fractal effect, send itself off of the field to the graveyard to go dump kit. And then Okay, so not dumping kit. Fair enough. Go dump Nerval. Then Nerval effect. Search out kit. Then Blossom effect. Special summon out. See, like, what I was talking about last turn, like, instead of Omen searching out Fractal, they could have Omen search out Nerval, and then, like, normal summon Nerval, bring out Blossom, turn Nerval into Amiraj, Nerval goes search for, like, the kit like they did there, but then they get to keep an extra Tri-Brigade name in deck, and I feel like that's pretty good. You know, you don't want to really be going through, like, all your Tri-Brigade names super quickly. Which they're not going through, like, all of them. You know, they should still have a kit left in deck. And at least one Karaz. Because, you know, they've gone through three Fractal, three Nerval now. I just feel like it's really, really, really important to keep your Tri-Brigades in deck to keep the grind game as long as possible. Especially versus a deck like Prank Kids, where this deck's grind game is just absolutely insane. Then they're going to activate kit effect, banishing two for cost, and then they're going to chain Bow Wow to add back. What are they afraid of for a banish two? That's interesting. Now they just get poked. Like, if you leave Bow Wow on board, that's pretty good, right? I guess, like, you could tribute it anyhow to, like, play around, like, the second Appaloosa, which has been becoming more popular, it feels like. Feels like I've been seeing that a lot more. And you're going to get rid of all those to go for access code and then get those effects. Yeah, access code 3. Go search. And then draw, put back. And they are going to keep the Imperm. Then Fusion Spell, get rid of those. Summon out Weather Washer. And then they are going to admit defeat there. So, also, since they put back the Revolt and kept the Imperm, I kind of feel like they're only playing two Omen. So, moving on to the next game, we are going to see Paulo be going first. Opening hands, we have Fusion Spell, Field Spell, Fusion Spell, Fire, Gamma. Again, this is good. Like, they have a Hand Trap, two Prank Kids names, a Fusion Spell, and, like, the Field Spell is so good for chain blocking. And then they have Fractal, Kit, Ash, Nerval, Fractal. That's a lot of Tri-Brigades. So they're going to start off with the Fractal effect, chain Gamma. This player just doesn't care about getting hit with Gamma, like, at all. Like, I remember in the last video, too, like, oh, it is so scary. Like, if you Gamma effect and they chain Gamma, like, it's so hard to, like, win that game. But normal summon out kit, get rid of it, go for Amiraj, kit effect, dump Nerval, Nerval, add Karaz, and then they will go ahead and they are going to activate the Karaz effect, getting rid of Fractal, summon out, and then Karaz effect. And they are going to banish two and go for a Bear Bloom. And then get rid of those. Go for Silver. And then Bear Bloom effect. Grabbing Revolt. And put back Nerval. Set. And then pass. So let's just say they banished four. They summon out Omen. And then they turn Karaz and Omen into a Blossom. They search. They summon effect. Banish the Omen and the Karaz to summon out Bear Bloom, and then go ahead and get rid of those for, like, an Appaloosa. You could end on, like, Appaloosa Revolt Ash. That obviously plays into more hand traps as you are extending further. And also doesn't play around, like, a Cosmic as well. But, you know, Appaloosa definitely being a pretty solid card versus this matchup. Draw fire. Then activate field spell. Searching out wind. I mean, last game the Appaloosa wasn't really that great. In this game the Appaloosa wouldn't really be that great either. Just because, like, they keep opening up fusion spell plus field spell. But summon fire. Activate revolt. This will go ahead and, you know, summon. And then get rid of them for omen. And then they are going to activate Nerval and Omen, go search out from the deck to the hand a kit, and then banish fire, and then fusion spell, said Prank's best deck, once again. Summon out Rocket Ride, and then get those effects. They will be summoning out Roxies and Water. They do have to dump, yeah. And then get rid of those, summon out Doodle, and then get all those effects. Search out Fusion Spell, Gang 1000. Water can't summon out Water, but we'll just pretend that Roxy summoned out Water and Water summoned out Wind. Same outcome, but they did mess it up a little bit. And then get rid of those to go for Bow Wow. And then go Battle Phase, End Domain Phase. They're going to activate Silver, Special Summon out Nerval. And then Battle Phase, Rocket Ride, Attack the Omen. No, because this is gaining 1,000 here. Yeah. And then Omen Effect, go search out Nerval, Bow Wow Attack. Then they are just going to let that get beat over. Doodle, Attack Silver. And then Silver Effect to make them lose some attack, but it doesn't matter since, you know, they already attacked with everything. Doodle Effect, Tribute, to add back Water and Fire. And then Rocket Ride Effect, Tribute, to summon back out Doodle and Wind. And then set Fusion, set Twin. And then end phase, Nerval goes back to hand. Pass turn, they draw Kuraz. That is a solid draw there. You cannot complain about that. Normal summon out Nerval. I mean, I feel like there was definitely other draws that they could have had too. Again, their build is a little bit whack. So like, there's got to be some like good cards that they could draw. They're going to use the effect to banish 4. And then summon out Omen. Omen effect. Chain Bow Wow. Tribute to add back Fusion Spell. And add back Wind. Then they are going to resolve. Hitting the Twin. They don't hit the Prank Gets Fusion Spell here. The 50-50 missed. And good on them too for adding back the Wind. So that way they can't just banish this. Definitely nice played there. They're going to summon Blossom and then get Omen and Nerval at Fractal. And searching out, they are going to go add the Beast of the Forest. Says Shivers. And then Blossom Effect, Special Summon Out Kit. Then they are thinking on the summon. They're going to activate Fusion Spell, said lost a 50-50. Yeah, it happens. For sure. Summon out Battle. And then get those effects. Chain the Battle Butler effect to go ahead and wipe the board. And this is definitely pretty good here. Go ahead and summon out Wind. Water. So it is a little bit weird that last turn they didn't set up Meow. Because they definitely had a chance to do it. The game one, it looked like they almost messed up summoning Meow. Like, they linked two away to go summon it, and they were like, oh, wait, summon them back, get rid of one, summon Meow, and then go for that play. So it looks like they just, like, forgot to do it again. Because they could have done it, right? Like, instead of just, like, linking two, like, away for like a link monster, you just link one away for Meow and then link both of them away. So I think they, think there was a little misplay. So let's play a bit faster because time is approaching. Cool. Kuraz effect. It's going to ditch, summon. And then Kuraz effect, banishing 1, 2, 3. Summon out Doom Eagle. Then go ahead and get rid of those. Not getting rid of those. Okay, fair enough. Technically, that was in that zone, but it doesn't really matter. They're going to get rid of those to summon out Access Code, Effect, Gang Attack, Battle Phase, Attack Doodle. And that will be a decent amount of damage there. Main Phase 2, Effect, Pop Field Spell. The Bow Wow is indeed protecting them here from the card effects. Then they are going to pass turn, draw Twin Twister. Like, yeah, like Prank Kids 100% win this. Wow, Prank Kids are really showing out here, like. Pretty good, pretty good. They're going to use those effects. Then they're thinking, so go grab Pranks, you know, gang 1,000, dump, and then not summoning off the wind. Go for Meow, fire effect, chain Ash Blossom to stop that, and then activate Pranks. And then Pranks effect, discard, go ahead and summon out token, and then go for, okay, they're going to use that to summon out Silver. This was properly summoned by using Bear Bloom and Kuraz at the beginning. Then go for access code, and yeah, the access code backed the access code. Wow. So, lost the dice roll, but still won 2-0. Like, sheesh. You know, this deck, again, people are just underrating this deck right now. I mean, to be fair, again, you know, they were drawing like a hand trap, field spell, prank kids, plus a fusion spell. But, you know, they could have also drawn like a poly. They could desires into those. There is a bug, bro. I hate them, bro. Again, like, crawling through the AC at night, and, like, I hate it. But, besides that, like, there's desires, pretty sure they're on talents. We did see that the one match, right? I'm not sure. I think it was them. But talents, you know, if you get hand trapped, you can just go ahead and use that as a draw two. If you have combo, they can use it to peep the hand and then just keep comboing. Whenever they use talents to peep the hand, you know it's bad. You know it's bad news for you. But seeing how long the match lasted, it did start right away, and it lasted 58 minutes long. Definitely a lot of thinking in this match, because it actually wasn't that many turns long, it didn't feel like. I wonder if Paulo thought about, like, you know, full comboing turn one. I mean, yeah, they probably thought about it. Like, come on, it's Paulo. He's definitely a very, very solid player. But he decided to under combo and just go for Silver, playing around like a Cosmic, a Twin Twister, which they are playing. Decided to not go for like the Appaloosa route, deciding that they just didn't need to go for that, which is definitely interesting, because you know, Appaloosa is pretty insane. That card is I don't even know. Like, Appaloosa is honestly crazy. Like, ever since that card came out, it's just like, wow, this is just such a good Link 4. Like, it's way too good of a card. Like, I don't feel like that card. I feel like there's going to be certain formats where it's not played, but I feel like that card is just never going to get, like, fully power creeped. Kind of like Zeus. Like, that card, card will probably never, like, it'll probably not be in certain formats, but I feel like that card will just always, like, be around. Like, it may not be there one format, but the next format, it's gonna be there in an extra deck or two. But with all that being said, that is it for this round. I will be back at it with the next round coming after this. The DB Grinder signing off. Peace. I'll be back soon.